Good evening, friends. I know we are starting late, but everybody, Ratanji was on one TV debate. General Bakshi was another TV debate. I was on another TV debate. So Ratanji and me are starting, and we have dropped a message to General Bakshi. He will join as soon as he gets the message. So I've started. Yeah, it is live. And if you are joining for the first time, please subscribe to the channel. I will not waste your time with introductions, as you see Ratanji every day on TV. Ratanji, India has a grave national security crisis of two dimensions, I feel. One is what happened in Galwan in June. And the other is there are people who say Indian variant and proudly tweet what is the harm in calling it Indian variant. And somehow the language they use is always a language which seems to favor China, even though very recently there have been major developments in US and in India, which conclusively show that at the very least it was a lab leak or it was a bio use. In the sense, it was manufactured in a laboratory. That bat or wild animals theory is out. What do you think on this dimension? First, India internal. Why are there so many people still supporting the Chinese view that it was just an animal thing while they are very comfortable calling it Indian variant?
See, to put it gently, I just reading today, one sentence by some wise man. The steel does not break. It is the rust which is created in the steel which actually then destroys the steel. So a lot of rust in our system where we decry nationalism, we decry patriotism, we love to invoke anti-national feelings in the name of dissent. It has gone too far. In fact, today I was in a debate about this NCC introduction in Kashmir and the kind of language being used by them against this introduction of NCC as an elective subject was unnecessarily abusive. And somebody said it's Modi ji trying to cover up this and that. It's a topic which is an elective subject. NCC was created by Pandit Nehru. It was a part of curriculum. Most of us who are in college one time or the other, it produces wonderful officers. They are directly recruited to the army. And that is happening in Kashmir also. So if a new course is created, then there is nobody's business to create any kind of outrage, but it was created. And these are same people who cry when terrorist dies. They are same people who support Chinese line or Kashmir. The same people who actually got money from the central government for years, living in comfort of their homes with Z-plus security, having villas in Delhi and various places, whose children never went for any stone throwing or for any terror attack. So this is the background of people who are celebrated in our country for times. There is image of PMs with the person who had very proudly claimed that he had killed XYZ army men. So if this is the background. If you celebrate JNU where they talk about, you know, Azadi and Desh ke tukde honge. And if you go back in history, Communist Party at that time, a faction of Communist Party had supported China during 1962 war. That particular virus has not gone because the particular faction came out and created CPM. And these are the people who were arrested during the Chinese attack. They had unions which disrupted the supply of transport vehicles carrying essential items to Jawans on the border. And that is the reason they were caught. They also tried to create a dissenting trade union group within the army in before 1962. This is the history. And it has become fashionable to be part of this crowd because one always likes to be rebel, whether it's for a good cause or bad cause. And if they are celebrated by people like Rahul Gandhi, naturally, there is a kind of market for these people also. And if you look at China, they have, I think, spent about $500 million on media relations, on PR. If Rajiv Gandhi Foundation can get donation from China, if they can sign a secret agreement, MOU with Chinese Communist Party, you can understand the rot that has set in. So this rot has to be exposed, only then this will stop. So all this support for China comes at a cost. I cannot blame or I cannot accuse somebody of what cost, but definitely there are pluses and various kind of perks that are given to these people. People who have seen these circuits, they know how it is given and how they celebrate and how they are offered money to write articles for favoring China. In fact, to tell you today, I was offered to write some good articles for China and which they will make me pay they will pay me for that. I said, sorry, unless it is legal, I will not take any payment. And of course, I never wrote. So that is the kind of approach these people have. And if they can spend $500 million on media relations, naturally, somewhere somebody in India is also benefiting. Otherwise, why should somebody take continuously Chinese line? China, which we try to create trust after 1962, very heavy cost. But that trust didn't materialize because basically Chinese have those Middle Kingdom's dreams even now of expanding beyond their borders, whatever at one time or the other was part of China. So then half of world belongs to China in that way, you know, almost. Entire South China Sea, you talk to the people. If you say it's a, you know, it's a commerce trade, you know, this South China Sea, they won't listen to any other word. So all the countries in the periphery are being threatened. China is trying to encircle India. If our people don't understand that, so enemy within is much more dangerous than enemy outside. You can catch the enemy outside, but you cannot do much about enemy inside. And we have seen it through various, you know, laws. TCA से लेकर जो चल रहा है उसके अंदर आपने देख लिया कि कैसे ये लोग हमेशा रॉन्ग एलिमेंट को अपोज ये सपोर्ट करते हैं और किसी भी पॉलिसी को ब्लाइंडली अपोज करते हैं. कोविड का इंजेक्शन हो, चाहे वो कोविड का इलाज हो, चाहे ऑक्सीजन हो. आज आपने देखा होगा 14 या 12 ऑक्सीजन के भरे हुए टैंकर फरीदाबाद में खड़े हैं, उनको लेने वाला कोई नहीं. ये हालत है आज. और ये कोर्ट में जाकर इन्होंने चिल्लाया था, इतने इन्होंने तमाशे की. आज जो बैठे थे टीवी के ऊपर ये रिगार्डिंग दिस एनसीसी कोर्स, ये तो करने की जरूरत ही नहीं, आप मिलिट्राइज कर रहे लोगों को. अरे भैया, डिसिप्लिन सिटीजन हर देश को चाहिए. हमारा दुर्भाग्य है कि हम डिसिप्लिन नहीं चाहिए, हमको क्योस चाहिए. मैंने आज कोट किया था, एक कोट करता हूँ मैं आपको, बड़ी मज़ेदार बात है, किसी को पता नहीं है. 1923 के काकीनाडा अधिवेशन में नेहरू जी ने हिंदुस्तान सेवा दल का यूनिफॉर्म पहना था. आपको पता है, नेट पे फोटो है. सो इन काकीनाडा कांग्रेस सेशन इन 1923 नेहरू जी वोर दैट हिंदुस्तानी सेवा दल यूनिफॉर्म एंड देर इज अ फोटोग्राफ विच इज डूइंग राउंड्स इन सोशल मीडिया फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम एंड ही वॉज शॉक्ड. ही राइट्स दैट ही वॉज शॉक्ड व्हेन कांग्रेस पीपल ऑब्जेक्टेड टू इट. दे सेड मिलिटराइजेशन इज लाइक ओवर थ्रोइंग सिविल गवर्नमेंट्स, इट इज नॉट गुड एंड दैट गोज अगेंस्ट द इथोस ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस. सो नो मिलिटराइजेशन, नो डिसिप्लिन, नथिंग ऑफ दिस सॉर्ट शुड बी गुड. एंड नेहरू सेज आई वॉज शॉक्ड. So that is Mr. Nehru who saw this virus of so-called non-violence and so-called of anarchy and total abhorrence of any kind of discipline that has created the kind of problem we see today. And of course, Nehru ji introduced NCC because he was not really a stickler of that kind of anarchy, that what was good for British should be good for India even today after independence, that you can in the name of civil disobedience destroy people's lives, disturb people's life, whether it's farmer agitation or CA, that is not really the kind of agitations we want in India. That was against British. Gandhiji didn't ask her to keep on carrying on this legacy this way. We have only one legacy of Gandhiji today, or sitting on Dharna. What else we do that Gandhiji did? So that is the root cause of all these problems.
Ratanji, you in the beginning talked about the communist mindset, and I was reading, and it's very interesting, that one of the tallest communist leaders, V.S. Achyutanandan, when he suggested that in 62 war, that blood be donated to Indian army soldiers. I do not know how many of audiences were even born that time or know about this. He suggested that in 62 war, the Communist Party does a blood drive to donate blood to Indian army brave soldiers. He was demoted. General Bakshi's call, I will just take it. Ratanji, if you answer this, please.
See, Congress, Communist Party has all along taken a stand which if anybody in this particular, their particular circle goes against the party line or goes against their loyalist, first it was Russia, then it was China, then is one group with China, one group with Russia. So their inspiration lies outside India. I will add to that, in after 1947, Stalin said this independence is not real independence. This is the independence of bourgeoisie. So we have to fight against this. So Communist Party eventually picked up arms, and Telangana, Andhra Pradesh area was the area of rebellion, armed rebellion, till 1951 before they were totally crushed. And then they agreed to come to the democratic lines. And he's not the only one. There are many other communist leaders. I think one was Raghavan in Kerala, was thrown out of the party, and he was harassed and persecuted for a long time. So this communist inspiration from outside, we know they are very happy about Kim Jong also. And this kind of appreciation of Communist Party, which is the religion they follow, where if you don't follow them, they have killed about 11 crore people between different countries, Russia, China, and North Korea. The latest is North Korea, but otherwise Russia was the biggest killer. Then it was China. So killing killing people who don't agree with their ideology is as Abrahamic thought or as exclusive thought as Islam or Christianity, where they believe that only their faith is true. So that is same line of thought that communists has at a particular point, they will follow that line. In fact, the line was they first they opposed British, but when British and Russia allied, they started supporting British in 1942. And in fact, they begged British to help them capture or catch Congress leaders of 1942 agitation. It's on record, there are letters. And Mr. Dange also submitted an apology letter in 1942. So that apart, point is that the Communist Party is always inspired by outside. Their ideology has no roots in India. That is a major reason why it fails. It's also a major reason why we find this kind of unhappy situation where Communist Party always takes a stand which may not be good for the country.
Thank you, Ratanji. Now, General Bakshi has also joined us. Something is on. I think TV is on. I think some TV is on in General Bakshi. He is settling down. So, friends, by the time General Bakshi settles down, we were discussing with Ratanji the internal threats, which I would like to continue on because that is very important. We have to first be united ourselves.
We have to keep on remembering, Ashkaran, that for the first time, Hello. Very openly, the extreme right Islamist elements, the extreme left Naxal elements and neo-left elements are all aligned together with so-called secular forces, so-called church or organized church. I will not say Christianity, but organized church. So this entire phalanx of people are together. The only enemy they find is Mr. Modi. So in the urge to oppose Modi ji, they have started opposing even India without realizing it, I believe. So that is Absolutely. The problem with this entire, axis of people from extreme right to extreme left. And that we have to always recognize. Every attack you will see, every criticism comes from the same group of people. You have been on the TV, I have been on TV. When you look at the faces, you know, ye oppose karne wale. Aaj tak maine 7 saal mein ek bhi policy ko, kisi bhi is particular group ko, ek bhi policy ko appraise karte hoye nahi dekha. In fact, maine kai baar Congress ko praise kiya hoga for certain things, but I have not found in the last 7 years anybody ever even appreciating one law or one policy.
Very interesting point, Ratanji, because I say this, that people who are patriots are generally way more generous in appreciating points. I also, so often, anybody can do anything right. And very often I'm about to tweet a praise to any opposition viewpoint, which I actually like, but then I realize this will never come back. As they say, this courtesy will never come back. So then I think, is being reasonable a flaw? That is a broader debate. One of the days when we are having on these concept debates, we will do it.
Haan, bilkul si, ek toh main baat hai na ki the people on the so-called liberal side are basically illiberal. So only their religion is true, what they believe, whomever they stamp as holy becomes holy. Whomever they believe in, a person who is not fit to sit in society, they will throw him to the wolves. So this high intolerance for any other view which is not theirs is what really exposes them very well in the last 7 years. I hope our people understand that this kind of totally one-eyed approach to all the problems in the society and only my view is right is typically fascist attitude, which people, when you throw words like fascism and throw words like liberalism and secularism, etc., these are all words which are used like religion, like exclusivist ideas, where nobody has any other place. We are much more tolerant. We are much more acceptable to all other ideas. We are open to every idea, like typical, Bharati or Hindus. They are not. So this is their problem. And most of that influence, tell me which of these people have their inspiration from within India. Whenever they talk about, you have to see from where they come, unka idea kahan, from where the idea flows, whom are they appreciating, what idea they're picking up from, whether they are from India or outside India. At the most, they will pick up an India idea, then try to split hair on that idea and say, no, this particular idea is Hindu, is Indian, but with that, but they'll try to kill the idea. So this approach of, you know, disowning what is good. And I will tell you a very interesting example. This goes to Nehruvian time in discovery of India. Nehru says that Harappan, he, you know, sings praises of Harappan civilization, this, that, very well worded book. And then he says, by all means, by all approaches, Harappan civilization was a secular civilization. Now tell me, jab 6000 saal pehle, 6000 years back, there was no other religion, there was no other faith, there was only dharma, whether Hindu or not, the name came later, but Sanatan dharma was there. So what did you mean by secular civilization? Because there are a few graphics, there are a few sculptures, all of them were typical Hindu deities, Rudra and all that, yogasanas and all. What did he mean by saying by all means it was a secular civilization? I have never understood that. When he talks of Takshila, he says wonderful university where Buddhists and Brahmins went to study, not Hindus. Hindu word comes only when there is to show you some in poor light. He says, I get very uneasy looking at the Hindu cultures in South. These are his words. Because as our curiosity had started reading that why Nehru hated RSS. That is my you know, journey when I started reading his book. I was very amazed. So this is the kind of mindset we are talking about.
But, okay, when General Bakshi is joining, let me add him because he has some audio issues. Yeah. General Bakshi, can you hear us?
Perfect. Yeah, now I can hear you. Yeah.
Namaskar ji.
Mona Republic ka sala chala ja raha tha.
मैंने वही कर चल गया आपके बदले मुझे बैटिंग करनी पड़ी
सर नाउ सो वेलकम जनरल बख्शी एंड एवरीबॉडी वाचिंग हु वाज वेटिंग जनरल बख्शी इज आल्सो जॉइन रतन जी एंड मी एंड इफ यू आर वाचिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड आई वुड आल्सो लाइक टू से आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू टेल यू रतन जी हैज आल्सो स्टार्टिंग हिज ओन यूट्यूब प्लेटफॉर्म टू टॉक टू ऑल ऑफ यू So please do go and subscribe there also. We need to build this ecosystem. Ratanji is our senior. We learn so much from him. And you should also go and learn and follow the channel. He will be starting it in a day or two.
Thanks, General. That's very large heart of you. And I think this is the approach all of us should have. That we must support each other.
Absolutely, sir. General Bakshi, so we were discussing internal threats. Chinese, communist, leftist, etc. But now let's talk about the external threat. Since of why is I was on debate with you, Republic Bharat, and you said this: it is either a lab leak or it is an act of war. The chances of animal transmission are officially, or let's say, almost certainly over. Would you please elaborate on that so everybody understands what we are dealing with, and then we will come towards the other aspects of this debate.
Thank you so much, Iskaran, and of course, my very dear colleague, Ratan Chardha ji. You know, ever since this COVID thing exploded, we have had 167 million global citizens who are infected and 3.5 billion, 35 lakh people are dead. 2 trillion is the hit to the global economy. The hospitality sector, travel, tourism sector have collapsed. You know, billions of jobs have been hit. It is worse than the Great Depression of the 1930s, which preceded the Second World War. Okay, I'm now talking as a military historian. You know, Iskaran, in India, you know what the toll has been, the way our economy is hit? We have 3 crore Indians infected. And over 3 lakh dead in all the wars fought after independence. We have not had this kind of casualty. So are we just supposed to sit back and take it lying down? And the bloody communists of this country, like that Vivek Srivastav, have been going around and saying, China is too strong. We should be non-aligned. For God's sake. 3 lakh Hindustani mar gaye. Wo kutte hai, nali ke keede hai. What do you think? You know, when the Pakistanis killed 45 Indian soldiers in Pulwama, we almost went to war. That is the price we are willing to pay to protect our citizens. Saab 3 lakh maar daale hain. एंड यू आर टेलिंग मी कि साहब बिजनेस एज यूजुअल है, चलता है, चाइना बहुत बड़ी पावर है, उसको मत थ्रेटन करना. वी नो द काइंड ऑफ पावर चाइना इज. चाइना हैज नॉट फॉट अ वॉर फॉर 42 ईयर. चाइनीज आर्मी इज अ प्रिंसलिंग सोल्जर, इकलौता बेटा माँ बाप का, ना वो मरना चाहता है ना माँ बाप चाहते हैं वो मरे, राइट. एंड देयरफॉर यू हैव अ सिचुएशन वेयर ही कम्स फॉर अ 4 ईयर कंस्क्रिप्शन पीरियड, ही जस्ट वॉन्ट्स टू कंप्लीट हिज टाइम एंड गो बैक टू मामा पापा. You know, there were photographs shown by the Taiwanese of some Chinese soldiers who were ordered to go to the Indian front. I have not seen babies cry like that, jo mummy ko chhod ke ja rahe ho. That country is not prepared to fight. So what do? This is the way they choose to fight, Ishkan. This is the way they choose to fight, by waging biological warfare. And the point is, how long will the world take it lying down? How long will we take it lying down? Aapne first wave se deal kiya, unhone second wave. First wave was not very lethal to Indian, because these viruses are genetically tailored. They were devastating in the United States. They were devastating in Europe, in Italy especially, right? But they were not very lethal to India. They were spreading well in the first wave. Then they tweak the virus and they send it back to you. I hope we know that the Chinese have established a virological laboratory in Pakistan under the DSTO, Defense Science and Technical Organization, run by the Pakistani military. And how difficult it is. You know, you can today freeze dry the microbio organism, and then you can carry it as frozen meat or something and re-aerosolize this when you reach the target country. Thoda sa garam kar dijiye aur bathroom mein chhod dijiye, kitchen mein chhod dijiye, 5-star hotel mein chhod dijiye, Bombay mein chhodiye, it will spread. Dharvi ki slum mein jaake chhod dijiye na, wahan bade sare sympathizers hai पाकिस्तान के और चीन के, वहां छोड़ दीजिए और दोनों वेज महाराष्ट्र से आए.
रतन जी, अब आई विल कम टू यू. सो दिस चैलेंज व्हिच इज वी हैव टू एनीवेज, आई वुड ऐड ऑन टू इट, वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर एज इफ इट इज द वर्स्ट केस सिनेरियो. वी हैव टू एज अ नेशन, एवरी नेशन सर्वाइव्स बाय बिलीविंग द वर्स्ट केस सिनेरियो. वी कैन नॉट live in Nehruji's world of nothing will happen because I'm a great intellectual and I'm very nice with everybody. What is the direction that you think we can do or we should do vis-a-vis internal threats or vis-a-vis external threats? What would you like to see being done in India, in Bharat?
See, we have already discussed the internal threat and we know that a lot of them are, these people have been exposed. I hope they go through the due process of law and get punished the way they should be. And people are questioning, even there is a debate where we are being questioned whether sedition law should be there or not. So these people can misuse these laws further. But then that's a different issue. So we have identified the internal enemies. People have to stop listening to them and they will be punished. They go beyond a certain point. And government is more firm about it. And though we make a lot of noise on TV, but actually those people go unscathed when they actually comes to law. And externally, we have to align with the world. The world has to go beyond a selfish interest. If you see, there are many European Union countries slightly signing agreements with China even now. USA, despite all the noises, is not really ready to go for the jugular of China because there are commercial interests there. So as long as we look at only commercial interest and we believe that we can somehow overcome this threat and we can then again be friends with China, that is a mistake, because world has paid a very heavy price. Planet Earth has paid a heavy price for this kind of perfidy which it has done. Now there is also name of US lab being involved in the same kind of research. Now General Saab has talked about Pakistan. If this is the kind of biofare for warfare that is going on, we cannot compromise on punishing the people or the country which has actually started the process. How to do it is a different issue. But when China was not a very big manufacturing hub, did world destroy itself? No, it was progressing well. it was growing well. Natural resources are not, just confined to China. If you look for only cheap goods and let people die for that, I think that is the worst price to pay. And we have to stop looking at cheap solutions just because it suits commercially. In the long run, China has to get isolated. It has to get punished by the world community. If other countries with much lesser crime, like you know, Iran, Iraq and Syria are made to pay, or Oman are, you know, these people are made to pay, all the Middle East countries, for some real or imaginary crime they did against America or so-called humanitarian issues, then naturally China has to pay a much bigger price, because those are overt wars. These are covert wars where innocent people have lost their lives. And if we can, if the US can have sanctions against, what is wrong with Iran, the way it has been sanctioned and made to pay very price? Is there any real issue? How Iraq was destroyed? What was the real evidence for destroying Iraq? The so-called Syria WMD. So if America can go to that extent for smaller countries or weaker countries, then it has to show muscle, it has to show its financial prowess. And, you know, isolate China. That is the best thing to do. Today, you cannot have nuclear holocaust naturally. But you can isolate and make them pay financially very heavy price. If we can get cheap goods, and we it doesn't mean that China can survive without exporting. Very simple. So we have to find those ways out to make them understand the price they have to pay. We cannot simply be bystanders and try to find excuses of, you know, letting China off.
That brings me to a question, General Bakshi, that there was a view, at least in the initial part of, I felt that view, in the initial part in UPA as well as in India, there has not been a major policy change vis-a-vis China, at least in the first 5-6 years. Before Galwan, at least, I did not see a major policy change, where it was believed that because China has such enormous trade with India, they would never become aggressive or enter into a warlike situation because of the trade being so favorable to them in the sense of the balance of trade. That clearly, before even this lab leak coming out, that stood destroyed by what happened in Galwan Valley. That trade will not be a reason for there not to be an aggression or there to be aggression. So what be A, and second, I'm asking you two questions, please answer both of them. Secondly, as a student of military history, do you think we are going back to the era of 1940s to 1980s, where the democracies and the believers of human rights would today or within 5 years have to come together against those countries which are not democratic? Do you think we will go in that direction? And for that to happen, US has to go in that direction. Let's be real, it is the global superpower. So what, both these questions, India as well as global, what do you think?
You know, Ishkaran, there was a thesis called the Rosenkrantz thesis that trading states do not fight. That means countries that have huge trade with one another, they have too much stake in one another to really go to war. That Rosenkrantz thesis was, you know, absolutely shot out of the sky in the Second World War itself, when Japan and United States, which were trading, went to war. And so did Europe and, you know, the rest of the world. So the fact of the matter is, the trading states, you know, trade will prevent war, is a very, very ridiculed kind of a thesis. It has not worked in the past. And those who still imagine that it will work, and they make concrete policy prescriptions. You see, Mr. Menon, the previous NSA, he, in his time, they came out with a, you know, strategy paper called Non-Alignment 2.0. And, you know, what it said about China was so shameful. And it is so sad that one of our military generals, I will not take name, was involved in bringing that up. And he said, we just can't fight China. We should just fight delaying platoon action. We should train the local people to do guerrilla warfare. We dare not fight China. We dare not fight Pakistan because they are both nuclear armed. We cross, one soldier crosses, and pop, nuclear bombs will start bursting in India and destroy it. Does India not have nuclear weapons? When you have nuclear weapons, you deter the use of them. When the Kargil war took place in 1999, we fought for 3 months. Jet fighters were used, Bofor guns were used, multi-barrel Grad rocket launchers were used 2 to 3 divisions attacked from the Indian side. There was a 2 brigades worth Pakistani troops in that area. Their artillery was firing everything. Did you see nuclear weapons being used? It was hogwash. A set of these Gandhian, you know, I'm sorry, as a military man, feel like abusing. The amount of damage they have done to India is unbelievable. You know, they kept on holding the Indian state back till Vajpayee ji took courage in both hands, listened to his army chief, navy chief, air force chief, and he went for it. And every single Pakistani was thrown out of Indian soil. You know, it lasted for 3 months. Not one nuclear bomb. The bluff should have been called then. But then, unfortunately, we had a Congress government again. And all these Gandhians and Ahimsa and world peace wala came right back. Mumbai, 26-11. What did you do to Pakistan? Did you strike back? Did you take revenge? Did you deter Pakistan? No, sir. You started sending dossier after dossier after dossier, hoping that the state which had recruited, armed, trained, sent these terrorists would take action again. I mean, they took all your dossiers, kilotons, and then they said, these are fiction. Matlab, itna se bada chaata agar ek mulk ke muh pe mara jaye. But hamare mein ye ganda ek jeen aa gaya hai, capitulationist. हथियार डाल दो जो भी बाहर से आए औरतें आगे कर ये है तला इस हमारा जमीर जो है वो खा गए क्षात्र भाग चाट गए सो दैट इज अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट की ट्रेडिंग स्टेट्स वोंट फाइट इफ यू हैड एनी डाउट दे किल 20 ऑफ योर सोल्जर्स इन गलवान इट इज आवर बॉयज ब्रेवरी दैट दे वेंट बैक एंड दे किल्ड दिस थिंग एंड वी शुड हैव कॉल्ड द चाइनीज ब्लफ We did to a large extent. But we went, sir, up and we climbed the Kailash Range.
I asked this question is, because to be fair, I did not see a major change in the first 6 years of this government also vis-a-vis China. Even today, absolutely. I was in debate with you. And even today, we do not at a governmental level name China or call out China as the aggressor or China as the big threat. We still do not at an official level do it. So that is a problem which is existing today also, as is borne out. You have not seen one statement on China by any top leader. So that is why I said, is that problem still existing? And what is the solution?
You see, the problem is with our bureaucracy, with our so-called steel frame, which wears down the will of every government that comes. And makes it conform to a kind of a deep state kind of a situation as exists in USA and Russia and China. There is a deep state. We have a bureaucratic deep state. We have a foreign minister who thinks he's waging peace all over the planet and possibly, you know, is a candidate for a Nobel Peace Prize. They think it is their job to wage peace and therefore their biggest enemy is the armed forces of India. They must be suppressed. They must be kept down. We got such a lot of, you know, tactical advantage by climbing and getting to the Kailash Heights. Why were we in such a hurry to give it up? Kya nani mar rahi thi hamari foreign ministry ki? Why were we in such a tearing hurry to give up the advantage that we had gained at such cost? Why did we give it for North Pongongso? What is the value of North Pongongso? Compared to South Pongongso, which is the real invasion route from Tibet to Ladakh. We had secured the heights. We were overlooking the Moldo garrison. Why were we sweating ki kisi tarah jo advantage is fauj ne namurad, fauj ne le liya hai, usko hataya jaye? This fauj must be made to fight at a disadvantage. And who gave you the assurance that if you vacate South Pongongso, you vacate the Kailash Range, they will vacate Depsang, they will vacate Hot Spring, they will, you know, vacate the Galwan Heights. They have not. They have not. They were so happy. We were saying, oh, look at them running back. Are they were so happy they got you off the Kailash Ridge without a shot being fired. you know, unfortunately, we have a bureaucratic framework that actually believes in Gandhianism. They actually believe we got freedom not because of Azad Hind Fauj and Bose, but because of Gandhi. Whereas the tragedy is we got freedom because of Netaji and the Azad Hind Fauj, but power was handed over to collaborators like Nehru. Collaborators who, to justify their rule, said we got it because of Ahimsa. Netaji had nothing to do. Azad Hind Fauj, 60,000 में से 26,000 मर गए. आपने बाकी वालों को फौज में वापस नहीं दिया, पेंशन बंद कर दी, ट्रेटर डिक्लेयर किया, ट्रेटर फॉर फाइटिंग द ब्रिटिश. अरे साहब, ये चोट बहुत गहरी है. अनलेस यू गेट ओवर द करेक्ट दिस बेसिक एटीट्यूडनल ड्रिफ्ट. रतन शारदा जी इज अ वेरी डियर पर्सनल फ्रेंड. आई हैव ग्रेट रिगार्ड फॉर हिम एंड माई लॉट ऑफ अदर कुलीग्स इन दी RSS. Tell me, since when has Gandhianism become the core philosophy of the RSS? I fail to understand.
I will take your question to Ratanji and add one line to it. Ratanji, the other day I was discussing and I said there has been this Mahatma Gandhification of our mind, where what has been taught in our school books is non-violence has led to independence. So this Mahatma Gandhification of our mind, and that is unfortunately true in various leaders also, where suddenly everybody starts praising it. Mahatma Gandhi deserves a lot of praise. He was.
Yeah, your voice got frozen.
Okay, I was saying this Gandhification of mindset, and as General Bakshi has posed the question to you, very often RSS is also asked questions on this glorification of this mindset, which is primating. So what would you say about both these things?
I'm surprised that internal external enemies debate and Chinese debate had turned to RSS. Somehow RSS is with whipping, very favorite whipping boy. See, RSS has consistently said, incidentally, I wrote a book called Sangh and Swaraj, which is in Hindi, English, Tamil, now being translated, also in Punjabi, and also being translated in Telugu and Malayalam now. It's a very small book where I have said very clearly that independence is not a result of three non-violent agitations over a period of 30 years. Every 10 years, there was an agitation. First one was this agitation of 1920, which was riding on the back of Khilafat, which was basically the founding, real founding stone for Pakistan. Second was 1930, which was again called back without full success. And third was our 1942, which got finished in about 75 days, nothing achieved. And this cannot be the result on which we got independence. RSS never said it. I don't know why these words are put in RSS mouth. In fact, RSS suffered a lot because of Gandhi's assassination. Now, then who got it? I reviewed a book called Mr. Casey Day's book on the role of how actually British documents show that British finally got tired of the INA trials, where they were very badly exposed, people got highly agitated, and they were ready to rebel, and followed by naval mutiny and Jabalpur mutiny, where British realized they can no more control India with Indian forces. They have no trust left, so we may have to call either more British soldiers, which we cannot. We have to spend a lot of money to get it, we cannot. So we better give freedom to India, and that was signed. After agreeing and making this declaration by Attlee, then India was partitioned to make it weaker. So this entire freedom struggle cannot be encapsulated in those three agitations. It has happened. But then who did it? Did RSS do it? Did BJP do it? No, it was Congress' own work. Wonderful PR machinery, full control on the media, full control on the narrative. Entire history was rewritten with the help of Marxists to destroy any other kind of link to freedom struggle. And this is how it happened. And RSS never followed that line. And coming to this Kshama and all that, Mr. Bakshi has on one side said that bureaucratic control is iske karan koi uske bare mein uske against ja nahi sakta. To RSS beech mein kahan se aa gayi? RSS is not one who believes in Kshama, Yachana, and ki bhaiya wo isko maaf kar do, dushman ko maaf kar do. ऐसा एक स्टेटमेंट आरएसएस का बता दीजिए जिसमें कहा है कि पाकिस्तान को माफ कर दो, बांग्लादेश को माफ कर दो, चाइना को माफ कर दो. एवरी रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ आरएसएस इज हाईली एग्रेसिव, हाईली पॉइंटेड ऑन अगेंस्ट ऑल दिस एक्सटर्नल एनिमीज. आई हैव डन अ पीएचडी ऑन दिस टॉपिक, सो यू कैन नॉट रियली क्वेश्चन मी ऑन दैट. and I can have a debate on that topic as my this book comes out in next 2-3 months. So to put the blame on RSS door is really very unfortunate. I respect Mr. Major General Bakshi a lot. I respect every other person who is in lot of the nation. But to bring home some point which is due to BJP is not correct. People say BJP RSS ek hi hai. With all due respect, BJP RSS ek nahi hai. RSS socio-cultural organization hai. BJP purely political organization hai. There are a lot of common areas where we work together. We respect each other. We love each other. Where required, we even work together. But it does not mean that RSS is going to dictate the government. It will not. It should not. That is my firm view. RSS is not part of government. It should not dictate terms to government. It has right to, you know, put its word, point of view. It puts its point of view. It's not, it doesn't. It is up to them to listen or not to listen. But this particular problem of losing or negotiating table, what we were in the foreground, is a sickness, which is a disease, which has not left us. I am not one of the people who try to justify what happened in Galwan Heights or why the military, you know, withdrawn. I never commented on it because I had different views. I don't want to create, you know, unhappiness in the nation because it's a very long-term war of attrition between China and India. And India needs to have a lot of nerves to keep on fighting on the long term rather than giving to special effects of 1 or 2 years withdrawing this or there. Teen mai lage, teen mai piche. That is not the issue. It's a long war of attrition, which it has to fight very very carefully. Whether what it did in China right now is right or wrong, now it looks wrong, we do not know. But that's why I have not spoken about it. And I'm happy that Major General Bakshi has spoken about it. But this affliction that we have is with us for a long time. 1948 se chal raha hai. 48 mein Pakistan ke logo ko bhaga rahi thi, par army usko rok diya gaya. 65 mein wo jo Haji Ali jo pass tha wo pass ko wapis kar diya gaya, Haji Pir pass ko. 71 mein yahi hua. In fact, surprisingly, 71 ki war ke baad mein, after 71 war, which India won very comprehensively, 93,000 soldiers under in our prisons. At that time, a part of Chum was handed over to Pakistan. How many people know this? 8,000 Indians were removed from there and they remained unsettled, displaced people within India for years together. They were given some petty amount to resettle in the new areas. And why was it done? Nobody knows. Nobody questioned. You have won a war. You have got 93,000 people under you. You did not get your own people released. You released all of them. You withdrew your troops. We did everything as per Pakistan, but we could not get when Pakistan at the weakest point. At that time, we tried to force it to resolve Kashmir and also handed over more land to them. Yane, chalo, garib aadmi haar gaya, thoda daan de de, uska ghar chal jaye. That kind of attitude. That particular mindset of the foreign ministry or bureaucrats, but there is political leadership. But it's an issue on which there is a lot of confidential talk why it happened, why it did not happen. It is claimed that military did it, military agreed to it. Military is very strong. If they didn't want to agree, they would not have agreed to it. But something happened. But as I said, it's an affliction that we have to get over. This government has gotten over this affliction in a big way when they counterattacked Pakistan. They went inside the territory. We knew their mindset had changed. They stood up in Bhutan. They stood up in Sikkim. They stood up in Ladakh the way no other government had done. At the last moment, that old affliction may have risen again, for which government has to respond. But RSS doesn't respond to that. With all due
respect. Two things, Ratanji, I would say. First, people who are joining, if you're watching for the first time, every guest speaks uninterrupted. This is not a TV debate where I interrupt anybody in 1 minute or 1.5 minute. People say they're full and then I take the question. And this was not a question on RSS by me. It was by General Bakshi. So I had to put it to you. And secondly, it shows a strong organization. People who don't like it, call it fascist and a military organization with military training. And people who like it would say it is not, strongly enough doing what they wanted to or would like it to do. I think that is the fate of every strong, big organization, that everybody would have different views. And as you know, I'm a huge, huge supporter of RSS. You are RSS, but I'm a huge supporter. So I would have no questions. Now to General Bakshi. General Bakshi, yeah, if you want to, let me add a question also.
Because before I have been misunderstood, I think I have worked very long with the RSS. I may not have been a part of it, but I think we have been working almost on parallel tracks for very long time. Why I said was that we expected, you know, I worked behind the scenes quite a bit from 2010 onwards. I was with the Vivekananda International Foundation and with Doval Saab himself for the director. I was deputy director. For 3 years, we went around every school, college, trying to, you know, trying to spread the Kshatra Bhav, the fighting spirit in the youngsters of India, so that a new India would emerge, which would give it back. I'm very happy we have given it back to Pakistan. We are a big power. You see, please don't misunderstand that I'm criticizing for the heck of it. I'm saying that when our government, which is ideologically backed by the RSS, came in power, the armed forces, and I'm giving you a very frank viewpoint, were expecting much more. Much more. Yes, a lot has changed from that sick Congress government, from that weak Congress government. But you see, when we look back at the end of the day, those major changes, as you yourself said, have not really come. And the best part was Pulwama. The best part was Pulwama. And even there, if we discuss in-house, I can tell you a lot of things that we should have done much better. Why, for instance, did we not have beyond visual range missiles with our air force, which outranged Pakistan? You know, we had to lose Abhinandan and then get so much to get him back. So the simple point I'm making is the expectations that we had around, the great expectation, in now Pakistan would be broken into two, into four. That was our expectation. It will take preparation. Unfortunately, the speed of those preparations, which we thought would have gone up tenfold, remained at the pace of the old government. And therefore, when the time came to press home, we were not ready. We were not ready. So that is one point.
But I will not move to RSS topic because this will become a completely different debate.
This is a totally different debate. So I will leave it here. I will leave it here and take it up you know, another time. What I wanted to focus on today,
we are debating.
It's a totally separate debate. We have got weird.
लोगों का गलत समझना इसके लिए 5 seconds.
Yes, sir,
प्रोक्योरमेंट 10 साल से प्रोक्योरमेंट कुछ नहीं हुआ था. जनरल साहब कई बार हर टीवी शो पे चिल्ला चुके हैं इस बात के बारे में कि 10 साल देयर वाज जीरो प्रोक्योरमेंट. वो प्रोक्योरमेंट 10 साल को कितने कम टाइम में हम रिफिल कर पाते. गन्स 30-30 साल खरीदी नहीं गई, प्लेन्स 30-30 साल खरीदे नहीं गए, जैकेट्स तक लिए नहीं गए, प्रॉपर फटीग लिए नहीं गए. वो अगर सब करेंगे तो नेचुरली इट विल इट हैज दे हैव ट्राई टू ओवरकम दैट गैप इन अ बिग वे इन लास्ट 6 years. It could have been faster. I don't know whether it can be faster because Mr. Parrikar broke every kind of protocol to make it faster. He was not afraid. He was honest. So he procured a lot more than any other government could have done. But yes, I am only worried about the psychology part, not about the arms, which army has and the all security forces, which is much better than what it was so far. My worry is only mindset. On that, I agree with Major General Bakshi.
If we come back to the topic, see, the thing is, and because I joke with the people on YouTube, we are a family. Both General Bakshi and Ratanji are so senior to me that they will decide where the debate goes. I can only request them to bring it back.
You can go to the next point.
That is the next point. So I can only request them.
Thank you.
So, General Bakshi, now let us, as I said, we have to...
revert back to China.
Back to China. So our belief that we have to prepare for the worst case scenario. So in that worst case scenario, what are the few things? Somebody asked a very good question. Are there some aspects of trade war which are relevant that we can do? But we have to be conscious of the fact Chinese economy is much bigger than ours. What are the certain aspects that you would think India should prepare for or move in direction of preparing for in case the worst case happens again? And then I will come to the international question.
Okay. You see, if you read the nuclear doctrine of the United States, you know what it says? Very interesting point. It says that if a country attacks the United States with biological, chemical, or radiological weapons, it will be treated like a nuclear attack and we reserve the right to respond with nuclear weapons. Jab ye tweak aaya in the American military doctrine, nuclear doctrine, you know, our own doctrine was modified to include this. Even the Indian nuclear doctrine says, if somebody uses biological warfare against you, India reserves the right to retaliate with nuclear weapons. The simple point is, if somebody has caused you 3 lakh people dead, 3 crores infected, fallen sick, if somebody has hit your economy so hard, please remember, and I request you, Ratan Sardarji is a very senior person, please remember, in all our wars after independence, India has not suffered so much. So are we going to do nothing? I'm sorry, doing nothing is not an option, because then you will get more and more and more. आप सेकेंड वेव से डील कर लेंगे, तकरीबन कंट्रोल में आ गई, ठीक है, थर्ड वेव आएगी, फोर्थ वेव आएगी, फिफ्थ वेव आएगी, और प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द नेचर ऑफ द अटैक. हाउ डिड दे गेट रिड ऑफ डोनाल्ड ट्रंप? बाय अ डिवास्टेटिंग वेव ऑफ कोविड इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट. जो कुछ काम किया था डोनाल्ड ट्रंप ने, धरा का धरा रह गया, एंड ही लॉस्ट द इलेक्शन. दे आर ट्राइंग टू डू द सेम to Narendra Modi ji. Let there be no doubt, there is a no holds barred campaign against you, and you saw the way the global, you know, media reaction was primed to insult and humiliate it. Humiliated. Aap second wave pe kabu paloge, third aa rahi, fourth wave aayegi, fifth aayegi, sixth aayegi, they'll keep tweaking the virus, sending it back. वापस भेजने में क्या है? एक बंदा स्टीक लेके आएगा आपके साथ, वो खाने की अपनी मैक्रोनी लेके आएगा, या अपना वो बर्गर लेके आएगा, उससे वो बायोलॉजिकल वॉरफेयर वेज कर सकता है. यू कांट ट्रेस इट बैक. सो द थिंग इज, वट एवर वी डू, वी हैव टू डिटर चाइना, एंड वन वे टू मेक चाइना पे इज बाय यू टेकिंग द एरिया. Why does it always have to be कि चाइना स्टार्ट करेगा, जैसे वो बंद करना चाहता है वैसे वो स्टॉप कर. We can only react, 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 react. हाँ, हमने react किया, हाँ साहब हमने भी मोबिलाइज किया, वो दो डिविजन लाया, हम तीन ले आए, फिर चार ले, उसको मतलब he had to उल्टे बांस बरेली को पड़ा, ठीक है. But nowhere have we concluded. What I don't know, I'll just finish. What I'm saying is, what can you do? Let's just basic thing is, what can you do? The Quad can put military pressure like it is already put. Dekhiye, Philippines took China to International Court of Justice over South China. International Court of Justice said Philippines is right, China is wrong. चाइना ने ठेंगा दिखा दिया, बट डिड चाइना गेट अवे विद इट? आज साउथ चाइना सी में 4 अमेरिकन एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर बैटल ग्रुप्स घूम रहे हैं. अमेरिका हैज गिवन F-16 एंड टैंक्स एंड अदर थिंग्स टू ताइवान, राइट? इट हैज पुट चाइना बैक अंडर प्रेशर. फ्रेंच एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर बैटल ग्रुप केम देयर, यूके का बैटल ग्रुप आ रहा है, हमारे जहाज जा रहे हैं, जापानी जहाज आ रहे हैं, ऑस्ट्रेलियन नेवी के शिप्स आ रहे हैं. काउंटर प्रेशर चाइना पे पड़ा है फॉर ट्राइंग टू कॉकस टू गेट द इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस, राइट? सो द वर्ल्ड विल हैव टू गेट टूगेदर. वी हैव अ गुड रिलेशनशिप विद द यूनाइटेड स्टेट, चाहे डोनाल्ड ट्रंप हो, चाहे जो बाइडन हो. ही नोज ही नीड्स इंडिया इफ ही हैज टू बैलेंस चाइना, राइट? So, we must put joint pressure. First of all, we must name and shame. Now, if you see the International Atomic Energy Agency, International Atomic Energy Agency, IAEA, can carry out intrusive inspection of nuclear plants in Iran, in many countries, all over the world. It can demand an inspection. So we need to tweak the biological warfare convention to give it teeth so that international inspection can be carried out of any virological lab anywhere in the world. Because after all, the world, sab, 3.5 million log mar chuke hain. Is that not enough deaths? Itni deaths aapki conventional wars mein nahi hui hai, sab.
General
you
Bakshi,
can't treat it as business as usual.
See, General Bakshi, you said the nuke option is not really any option for any country unless everything else has failed or anything else has. We hope it never happens also. But this global question was the second question I'd asked you initially, and when we digressed into other topics. So the point is, do you think this international pressure building up, do you see the signs of it? Because what I found very interesting is throughout the US elections, you did not have a mention of lab leak. But after the government changes, when it is no longer a domestic political priority, you have won what you had to win. The deep state, suddenly the intelligence report comes that we need to dig more. And suddenly the President Biden comes up and says, I will give 90 days to intelligence agencies. And God knows how many they have, because they actually have a very rich, very strong deep state. Eisenhower called it an industrial military complex, which has only become way, 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 way bigger. So do you think now that their domestic issues are over, they are also nationalists, they are also patriotic people who love their country, do you think a Quad would become stronger and we would move in that direction? And second question to that, do you think India will, for that to happen, India will come out of it, its non-aligned 2-0, 3-0, 5-0, 10-0 mindset, where we don't take sides, be it Israel and Palestine, be it Quad versus BRICS or whatever, we just do not take sides. Do you think that would finally happen? So internationally, what do you see?
Look, the simple fact is you could be non-aligned between Russia and America because both were far away from your border. Russia had never attacked you directly, nor had America attacked you directly. China has attacked you directly in 62, and once again it is putting you under military pressure. How can you be non-aligned against somebody who attacks you? And now they have attacked you biologically. So this non-alignment nonsense, the earlier we get rid of it, the better. You can be non-aligned. If wo dono dur dur hain, aapas ki ladai kar rahe hain, humko kya lena tha? Are saab, China aapke border se lagta hai. Aap pe ek baar attack kar chuka hai, 3800 sipahi maar chuka hai. Ab usne saab dusra aapke upar dabaav dala Ladakh mein. Aur saath mein biological warfare cheda. Aapke 3 crore logon ko bimar kiya. Aur aapke 3 lakh log maar dala. मार डाले, let there be no doubt, छुपने की कोशिश मत करिए, वो शुतुरमुर्ग रेत में सर दे दे, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि खतरा टल गया, आपके लोग मारे हैं, आपकी जानें ली, आपके कफन यहाँ पे उसने खुलवाए, चिताएं जलाई, 3 लाख, अब आप कह रहे हैं कि हम non-aligned होंगे इसके बाद भी, I don't think so, I don't think you have that luxury. Unless you have lost all strategic sense. Chanakya ne kaha tha, mere dushman ka dushman, mera dost. Theek hai? Agar America aur China ki bhidan hai, kyunki America kisi ko number 2 ko number 1 nahi banne de. Nahi banne diya, World War 2 mein unhone Germany ko haraya. World War 1 mein bhi Germany ko haraya. Jab usne dekha, bahut zyada taakatwar ban raha. Japan ko haraya. जब देखा बहुत ज्यादा ताकतवर बन रहा है वो चीन को पीछे भी पड़ गए हैं डोनाल्ड ट्रंप तो हाथ धो के पड़ गया था ये कैलिब्रेट कर रहे हैं थोड़ी देर में दबाव आएगा मिलिट्री स्टेट डीप स्टेट उनको उसी दिशा में ले जाएगा यू हैव टू बी एबल टू बैलेंस चाइना उसके लिए टू कंट्रीज व्हिच आर वाइटल इन एशिया आर इंडिया एंड जापान यू मस्ट हैव अ स्ट्रांग रिलेशनशिप वेदर अमेरिका कम्स इन और नॉट कम We must be very strong relationship with Vietnam, with Taiwan, with South Korea. Right? First tier, second tier. First tier, India, Japan. Second tier, mein India, Vietnam, South Korea, Taiwan. Agar hum log ye balance kar dein, power, बैलेंस ऑफ पावर आर्किटेक्चर हम चाइना को कंटेन कर सकते हैं. अमेरिका विल बी रिक्वायर्ड, अमेरिका विल कम इन एंड अमेरिका विल हेल्प यू बिकॉज इट ऑल्सो वॉन्ट्स टू कंटेन चाइना. सो दैट इज नंबर वन, राइट. आई एम सेइंग दैट इन इफ वी फॉलो इंडियन नेशनल इंटरेस्ट देन वी हैव टू अलाइन विद द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एंड द क्वाड कंट्री, राइट. वी मे नॉट फॉर दैट हैव टू ब्रेक अप विद रशिया. वाई शुड वी ब्रेक अप विद रशिया? रशिया इज ऑल्सो सस्पिशियस ऑफ चाइना. Russia also has suffered in COVID. Russia has never attacked you directly. Okay? It has always stood by you. So we will, the only non-alignment concession that we may give is to Russia. Because it is a tried, tested relationship. Like Israel, like France, Russia is a tried, tested relationship partner. Gives you weapons cheap, latest technology, which America is not prepared for. So we can't cut off with Russia. But we can certainly hold our own against China. कि ये थीसिस के हिसाब से वाय घुटने टेकने के काउटाउ करने के कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है भारत के पास. ये विवेक श्रीवास्तव बोल सकते हैं क्योंकि वो जन्म जात के गद्दार हैं. Any patriotic citizen can't say that.
Sir, I will take the question, Ratan Sharda ji, of last question to each of you because we are already over 1 hour. So, Ratan ji, one question to you, the mindset question. And because I am raising this, because even with Israel and Palestine issue, whatever we spin it as, Israel thanked 20 nations or 25 nations, did not thank India. And we abstained both sides. We did not take sides. So somehow non-alignment, as the Gandhian Gandhification of our mind has happened, non-aligned is, I think, has seeped into our blood. To a great degree, we do not like to take sides.
इसको गांधीफिकेशन मत बोले, दिस इज नेहरूफिकेशन. नॉन-अलाइंड मैन की बीमारी जो थी वो नेहरू जी की उपज थी, वो गांधी की उपज नहीं थी. गांधी वाज वेरी क्लियर व्हेन ही टुक साइड्स इवन इंटरनेशनल मैनर्स वेदर राइट और रॉन्ग. कई बार उन्होंने रॉन्ग स्टांस लिया, हार्डली राइट लिया. उन्होंने हिटलर को भी लेटर लिखा था कि आप हिंसावादी हो जाओ वगैरह वगैरह. विल नॉट गेट देयर. बट आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस नॉन अलाइंड मूवमेंट वॉज अ माइंड सेट विच वॉज क्रिएटेड बाय नेहरू जी. इट नेवर सक्सीडेड, इट ब्रोक डाउन. एंड दैट माइंड सेट हैज चेंज अ लॉट. आई थिंक आई विल नॉट से नॉट चेंज, इट हैज चेंज अ लॉट. बट एज आई सेड लास्ट मोमेंट, नेगोशिएशन टेबल वीकनेस इज नॉट येट गॉन. एंड एज फार एज क्वाड इज कंसर्न्ड, आई थिंक इंडिया एंड यूएसए आर वर्किंग टूगेदर. इन फैक्ट just yesterday Australian leader said that India should lead the way for this alignment on the around South China Sea and around Indian Ocean. So people are ready to give the leadership, but leader has to take a stance. A leader cannot say I will not take stance, I will not name the enemy, I will keep balancing the two things. But see, Palestinian Israel relations have been balanced very well by Modi government before any other government ever did it. He very openly went along with Israel. He also kept on supporting Palestinians. But this is the first time when he did not balance one visit with the other. So it was customary to go to Palestine if you want to talk to Israel. It was stopped. But yes, in this moment, why it was not done, I think Israel has no problem. Israel understands it. But there is a long-term relation with Israel. Israel, the biggest exporter to India is Israel in terms of Israel's own weaponry export. So we should not fear that. My fear is that in the Indian Ocean and South China Sea, whether India will take the leadership as Australia wants it to take, and whether it will be able to get US along, because US also not had a certain, I would say, very egoist style of approach. Where you remember when they came to Indian Ocean, they said, we don't want anybody's permission, etc. So they also have to come down the high horse, because America is no more the monopoly. It is fighting an enemy of China's size, China's clout. Now China is trying to make its own currency as the international currency. If it does that, what happens to US dollar? Think about that. US has been able to kill those nations which went against US hegemony. Libya wanted to bring back the gold standard. That entire country was destroyed. Those who wanted to talk about oil control, they were destroyed. That is one part, but US can no more do that, because no more that strong a state it was. This idea of having a great country is no more present. It is no more the kind of dominant country it was. It has gone weak in trying to balance with China. So unless it realizes it and there is some person who is unpredictable as Trump, China cannot be controlled just by talks. As I said, which I agree with General Bakshian, I said earlier also before he came, that we need to isolate China economically very strongly. It will take a little time for India, but others can do it and we should do it. That is where the solution lies, because China cannot prosper without its export industry, because that is the main economy. They have huge population, no doubt, but the real cream comes from exports in every category. So if that can be controlled, not talking about one penny saved, etc., then definitely China can be tamed. So that is my viewpoint.
General Bakshi, last question to you, and I will follow from Ratanji's question. Do you think India is doing enough to take the leadership in the Quad countries, in our region at least? Are we doing enough? Are we poised to do it? And what do we need to do it to ensure that?
You see, what I would like to take on from where Sharadaji left off is that, is it a bipolar world now? I think it is a world tending towards multipolarity. And in multipolar equations, both before World War I and World War II, there were multipolar equations in place. Multipolar equations are characterized by rapid alignment and realignment. Let me give you an example. At the start of Second World War, Russia and Germany signed the No War Pact, Hitler-Ribbentrop Pact. By the middle of the war, they were both fighting. America deliberately, you know, delayed its intervention in Europe to let these two countries bleed one another to death. And very frankly, it is only when the Soviet Union rolled back the red tide from the gates of Moscow, almost they reached Berlin, that is when America jumped into the fight, right? And similarly, Italy was allied to Germany at the start of the war. Then it was defeated and it joined the Allies. So alignment, realignment. What remains constant is national interest. Right now, China is the hegemon. China is the greatest destabilizer. It is the greatest threat. It has hit you in Galwan. It has hit you in Ladakh. It has hit you with COVID. Let there be no doubt. You have been attacked biologically. You have been made to pay a price of 3 lakh Indian dead. You can't take it lying down. You have to align with whosoever will go against China. If it is America, fine. If it is not America totally, then you need to cultivate Japan. You need to cultivate Vietnam. You need to cultivate Taiwan. You need to cultivate South Korea. Make an alliance there. You have to be making your own alliances. And forget about all this non-aligned nonsense. We will be aligned to whosoever supports India. Bharat ka rashtra hit sarvopari. India comes above all.
That is the best note to end, friends. Ke Bharat ka rashtra hit mein. And we have to look out for our national interest. And very interestingly, it could be a multipolar world. We have to see, world is growing very, very fast. So I hope you all enjoyed this discussion. If you're watching for the first time, subscribe and share it with all your friends so that these wise words of Ratanji and General Bakshi get spread and you hear an exhaustive discussion on the topic. Thank you so much, Ratanji, for your time. And thank you so much, Bakshi ji, for your time. I took a lot of time. It's 7:30 in the night. Thank you so much.
Jai Bharat, Jai Hind.
Jai Bharat. Thank you.